Bonjour, this is Emma at Words and Peace, and today I have a very special project for National Poetry Month. One of my friends, Chris, who's a book blogger at Wild Moo Books, co-hosts a podcast with Emily called Book Cougars, Two Middle-Aged Women on the Hunt for a Good Read. And for National Poetry Month, so the month of April, she invites friends to video themselves reading a favorite poem. So, because I'm French, I've chosen a French poet, and I'm going to read it in French and then in English. The French poet I chose is Louis Aragon. He was born in 1897 and died in 1982. He was a poet, but also a novelist, a journalist, and he wrote a lot of essays. Many of his writings, including poems, are politically oriented. He defended communism, but he also wrote a lot of love poems and for the love of his life, who was Elsa. Elsa Triolet was her name. And he's also one of the main poets of the Surrealist movement in France. I chose the poem called Il n'aurait fallu, which was published in 1956 in a collection called Le Roman Inachevé. Now, if you know French, you know that roman usually means novel, but here he used it in a kind of medieval sense of the word. So it's definitely, even though it's called Le Roman Inachevé, it is actually a collection of poems. Now, why did I choose this poem? Well, it's a love poem that I really enjoy a lot. And I presented it at the baccalaureate back in 83. For the French, so baccalaureate, as you know, is the final exam at the end of high school and in order to enter university in France. And for the French part of the exam, the exam related to your French studies, there's a written test, which is a long essay you have to write. But for the oral part of the test, during the year, you study a large collection of texts of different genres. And then on the day of the exam, the interviewer, let's say, chooses one text and asks questions about it. Usually, students dread that that would be interviewed on a poem, but I really love poetry, so the teacher chose this, and it really went really well for me. I'm really good grade for this. And now, though, when I was preparing this video, I was horrified to discover that there are very few poems by Aragon translated into English, it seems. If you find a lot of collection, if you find this collection, please tell me. I did find, however, an approximate translation of it because this poem was also sung by Léo Ferré, and someone translated the lyrics of the song. And by the way, I'm going to give you down below the video also the link to that song by Léo Ferré. But really, in English, it feels rather dull to me, and it doesn't seem to justify that it would be one of my favorite poems. And so if you happen to know French, I hope you can really enjoy and appreciate it in the original language as well. Another favorite French poet of mine is René Guicadou, and even less of his poems have been translated in English. So I stayed with Louis Aragon. I'm going to read the poem in French and then in English, and I'm going to give you the text at the same time. Il n'aurait fallu qu'un moment de plus pour que la mort vienne, mais une main nue alors est venue qui a pris la mienne. Qui donc a rendu leur couleur perdue au jour, aux semaines, sa réalité à l'immensité des choses humaines? Moi qui frémissais toujours je ne sais de quelle colère, deux bras ont suffi pour faire à ma vie un grand collier d'air. Rien qu'un mouvement, ce geste endormant, léger qui me frôle, un souffle posé, moins une rosée contre mon épaule. Un front qui s'appuie à moi dans la nuit, deux grands yeux ouverts, et tout m'a semblé comme un champ de blé dans cet univers. Un tendre jardin dans l'herbe où soudain la verveine pousse, et mon cœur défunt renaît au parfum qui fait l'ombre douce. And here is the English translation. It would have taken just a moment longer for death to come, but a bare hand then came and took mine. Plus, you know, in French it's rhyming, so it adds a huge dimension for me. And of course, doesn't rhyme in English. It'd probably be very difficult to make it rhyme. Who brought back their lost colors to days and weeks, its reality to the immensity of human affairs? I, who shook all the time with unknown angers, two arms were enough to make in my life a big necklace of air. Just to move, this light gesture, when asleep rushing me, a breath hanging less than dew over my shoulder. A forehead resting against me in the night, two eyes wide open, and everything seemed to me like a wheat field in this universe. A gentle garden, grass where suddenly verbena grows, and my defunct heart is reborn to the perfume that softens the shadows. So this was my input for National Poetry Month. I hope this will be a nice opportunity for you to discover poetry. And maybe why not also do a video yourself. And I'm also going to give you the links if you want to have it shared with Chris and Emily for their podcast series. And enjoy the coming spring. See you later on Words and Peace.